Hi Triathletes, welcome back to another session with TriathlontesSA. Today, I thought as most of us are down in lockdown and we need to train indoors, I thought I'd share my pain cave with you guys. So you guys can see how easy to set up your own garage or spare room to make that into your pain cave during this lockdown period. So stay tuned as I share my pain cave with you. Okay guys, so before we move indoors, let me first show you the outdoors. As you can see at the back, I have a nice swimming pool to swim at home, but lately that has also proved some difficulty as my swimming pool is now turning into an ice bath. So just to show you guys, as you can see, the temperature is about 20 degrees. Now normally an ice bath is between 10 and 15 degrees. So slowly but surely, my swimming pool is starting to turn into an ice bath. So let's move indoors and then I'll show you the setup of my pain cave. Okay, you guys, so now let's move indoors so I can show you guys my pain cave. You'll see over in the corner, I have a treadmill with all of my medals up beside me, so I have something nice to look at. When you look at my treadmill setup, if I'm on my treadmill, the view would be of outside. So I'm not running into a wall when I'm running, but I have a lovely view of the outside when I do my treadmill sessions. You can also see that my treadmill has manual settings that go from 2 to 14, but it can also go up to 15 for incline and speed, which is more than enough for me to do my indoor training sessions on. Also have a small towel to cool me down when I get too hot, and I can also place my water bottles over here when I do my sessions. And then I have this nice lots of medals to look at. So when I'm a bit demotivated, I'll just look to the side and see the medals. I've also put up a small picture here to show me what the speeds of the treadmill and outside running would be, so I know exactly which paces I'm running at when I'm running on my treadmill. Before we move on, you'll see I have a fan over there. Usually I would just put the fan on the bench press so the air would be blowing in my face so I'd be cooled down when I run indoors. And then if we move to the side, you'll see I have a couple of bicycles. First, let's look at the mountain bike. That will be my specialized epic mountain bike, which would be a 12 speed 1x12. And then right next to it at the back, you would see my specialized LS road bike, which had some nice tri bars on there, so I can also take that out for a ride. You'll notice that the wheels are those of a felt bike. I took that off my TT bike and put that on the normal road bike because I bought some aero wheels. Then before we move on to the bottom, I'll quickly show you the setup of my bike. You'll see currently it's standing in the air, so when I do a treadmill session, the bike will be in the air, and if I do a bike session, I'll just put the bike down, and then you'll see at the back it's on my Elite direct drive trainer. Now my felt TT bike has an 11 speed cassette at the back, and you'll also see that I have an Adamo saddle to help me to stay more aero. My aero bars, you'll see, are the ones with the 90 degree angle, so it's much easier for me to stay down in the aero position. And then over there you'll see on the jump box, there's a take lot box. Usually I'll just move that to the front, so I'll just put it here, and then I'll put my laptop on top, and then I can train on Zwift as well. Okay, so let's put the bike back so we can move on. You'll see I've used one of my swimming pool buoys at the back to put the handlebars on, so my bike does not get damaged at all. So now to the wheels, you'll see I have a couple of 50 mil matrix carbon wheels that I usually use in races. And then at the back you'll see some cleaning stuff that I use to clean the treadmill and my bike as well. And then over there you'll see my running shoes and cycling shoes. First off would be the Hoka Bondi 6 that I use for running. And then if I do speech sessions, I'll rather use the Asics that I've spoken about earlier. Then my cycling shoes, I like the Shimano Tri shoes, but I also have a couple of Scott mountain bike shoes, as well as a couple of trail running shoes. Then at the top, you'll see there's a normal helmet and then my Cask TT helmet on the side. And over there, you'll just see a couple of spares. And at the bottom, you'll see I have a box where I threw in lots of spares with the jumping rope. And then you'll see that most of my stretchy cords are in this Trojan bag. So let me quickly show you what's inside. The stretchy cords that you can find inside all came with this box from Trojan. So you'll see on the side, all these came within the box. So you'll find the three different stretchy cords, and then you have the bag, as well as a doorknob that you can put under your door if you train indoors, and then some handles, and then the one that I use for swim training when I'm on dry land. So when you look inside, you'll see I have all of them on the inside. So first off, there you'd see the one with the stretchy cords that I use for dry land swimming. And then with that, I'll also use stretch cords that will help me to do strength and mobility training as well. And then on the side, you'll see I have two bladders from Camelback. One is a 2 liter and the one is a 1.5 liter. So when I'll be cycling more than 3 hours, I'll usually use the Camelbacks when I'm out on a mountain bike ride. But when I'm out on the road bike or the TT bike, then I'll rather use the water bottles or the TT setup for that. So that I'll just use for the mountain bike. And if you go up here, you'll see there's a couple of stuff within my helmet. So let me quickly show you what's on the inside. You'll see that I have my glasses inside. So when you open it up, you'll see that it's the glasses that I've mentioned in one of my previous videos, where you'd find the glasses with the different types of lenses that you can adjust it with, as well as the add-on where you can put your prescription glasses inside to put on the inside of your cycling glasses. And then you'll see I also have a couple of nutrition stuff in there. So when I'm out on my ride, everything is in there. Lastly, on top you'll see I have 2 bottles of squirt that I use to loop my chain, and then I have some tissues which I'll always have with me when I'm out on a ride. And then in this little box, you'll see I've put all my tools, so that's usually with me when I'm out on a ride as well. There's my Garmin 520, as well as something for running in the dark, as well as my MP3 player and my Top Peak top tube bag, which I can put on my nutrition. And then I just have a couple of towels on top. And then if you move backwards, you'll see I have a jump box over there. So for that, I'll just move away this ball here so I can do some box jumps. And then you'll see my foam roller, as well as a 4 and a 6 kilogram kettlebell, as well as a 12 kg throwing ball. And then you'll also see there's a couple of weights that I can use. And then I love to do mobility exercises on the ball as it isolates certain muscles. And then lastly, over here you'll see I have a bench press that I usually do bench presses on, and there is my yoga ball. And then just at the top, I hanged all my running medals. So you guys can see all the running races I completed since 2016. And then if we move to the side, you'll see all the cycling races I've completed since 2016. And then lastly, all the triathlons that I've completed since 2016 when I started doing triathlon. So that's my pain cave setup. You guys can do it however you like. Just make sure that everything is set up nicely and there's enough space for you to still do your exercises as well. I've just used 2 normal hangers to hang my bikes on, so they take up less space and I have more space to train on. So you guys are more than welcome to share pictures of your pain caves in the comments, or send me an email at triathlon.tessa@gmail.com. So I hope this gave you guys some inspiration as on how to set up your pain cave, as well as to make training more comfortable during this lockdown period. I hope that this has given you guys some ideas on how to set up your pain caves during this lockdown period, or how you can set it up during winter training months. I'm also in the process of having some interviews with a couple of specialists with swimming, biking, running, strength and mobility training, as well as nutrition and recovery. So once those videos are shot and edited, I'll also place them up for you guys to see, so you will have some expert opinions on triathlon matters. Thank you for watching this video. Please go and like and subscribe to my YouTube channel up here. Also, check out my Facebook group and Instagram on TriathlonesSA, and the website at www.triathlontesSA.com. So keep up the training and stay motivated during this time. I'll see you guys soon.